אז אני תגיד את זה שכולם ישמעו, זה חשוב. Oh, good evening, dear women, righteous women. Let's first, בעזרת השם, ask that שיגיע משיח, צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. שיגיע מבשר אליהו, הנביא אליהו, תשבי אליהו, במהרה ממשיך בן דוד אליהו, הנביא זכור לטוב. Dear women, listen, I had a question before I start the lesson. If a person feels anger and hatred towards other people, dear women, first he hurts himself. He does not hurt them. He first hurts himself. Why? Because when we are angry, everybody can see, you know that, it's a personal feeling. You feel that your stomach is like this, נכון? Like it shrinks your stomach. You feel it. You feel your throat over here, like it's closing. Why? Because anger and hatred is judgment. And everything that is judgment causes us to come to a narrow place. מן המיצר קראתיך, מן המיצר קראתיך, King David says, מן המיצר קראתיך השם, which means from a narrow place I'm calling you Hashem. And you know, you can think about it when you have, God forbid, people, enemies, or you don't speak to people. What happens? We go to a wedding and we don't speak with A, B, C, D, okay? A few people, we don't speak. So when we come to this wedding or to this party, we feel very embarrassed. We know we cannot speak. We cannot look at her. We should sit somewhere else. Maybe she's speaking about me. Maybe she's not. Then we're in a narrow place. We cannot even breathe because we feel the anger. We'll feel the anguish. And where it goes to, it goes to the throat and the stomach. La tiferet. La tiferet. This is the measure of tiferet. Mamash. And you can feel it. And all of this causes sickness. And if you are not sick now, God forbid, you can become sick later when you become older, because everything stays in the same place. Only if you did tshuva. If you do tshuva, then you can clean also your body, because all of the souls, Ramach Evarim V'Shasa Gidim, which means 248 organs and 365 veins, are inside the body. And the body has the same veins and organs, the same number. So everything that we do influences what we have in our body. Listen, you know why when we sleep and we dream and we see somebody that passed away, we can see him in the same image that he was in life. Mm-hmm. We see him, but this is very weird. Did you think about it once? How can we see him in the same image? Because even if he comes to us in the dream, we know that he passed away, so the body is in the ground, already was rotten in the ground. So how come he comes with us in the same image? This is the image of God. Because everyone, you remember the first human being, God showed him all of the generations. And it says in the Midrash that he showed him all of the generations exactly the way they look today. All of the generations. How come? How can this be? Because we know that when we go to a different phase, when we pass away, so the soul goes out of the body, but the soul has a different clothing. The clothing over here is the body, but inside the body, the same shape that we have, there's also a shape that is spiritual. Mamash levush ruchani, and this shape that is spiritual looks exactly like how we look in this world, exactly, but it's very light. It can go quickly, distances, which we cannot do, because we cannot pass through a wall, but this shape can.
It's not physical.
And look, even though the wall is physical, look at the tzfifut, the density of the wall. If we could have just separated this tzelem, the image of God from us, we can also go different places. How come the tzaddikim can be in one place, and then can tell you that they study Torah? For example, a tzaddik that said, yeah, I'll give you an example. Rabbi Shalom Shabbos, Zichutot Hagen Aleinu. He used to study Torah and he used to study in Tzfat. But he was in Yemen. He never went to Tzfat. He never went to Jerusalem. This is how to know how to separate this tzelem, this image of Hashem, from your body by meditation, and let it go somewhere else to study, or let it go to yeshivot. To mamash, study over there in the true world, in a yeshiva, and come back like the Arizal and all the great rabbis that we had. Because this is to know how to separate yourself from the spiritual part that can go and study and come back. Do you understand? So that's why we have this image of Hashem. this is the image that we have to, this body we have to cleanse in order to really truly have the image of Hashem, because we spoke about it. We have three steps in worshiping Hashem. You remember we spoke about it. We have Yirah, the fear of God. We have Ahava, then the love of God. And then we have Bekut, the cleansing, the attachment to Hashem. And the goal, the end goal, is to be Tzelem Elokim. Tzelem Elokim, which means to have the image, the likeliness. Tzelem v'dmut Elokim of Hashem. We cannot have it unless we change ourselves, fixing our measures, לתקן את המידות שלנו. Because even if we study Torah, if we have bad measures, all of this Torah does not go to the place that we want it to go, under the throne of Hashem, dear women. So we have, first of all, to work on ourselves. If we work and we do tshuva, anyway God will give us help. Anyway God will give us everything that we need, but it depends on us, on our true will to change ourselves. We came to this world in order to fix all the avarot, all the sins that we have between each other. That's why we meet each other. We came, we already met each other. We are the reincarnation of the generation in Egypt. And I'm going to show it to you now, because we are starting Chumash Shmot, B'Sha'a Tova. We are starting Exodus, the second Chumash. So I would like to show you that the first sentence that starts it, it's written, first of all, don't forget that I gave you a lot of lectures about Shmot. So you have it on TorahAnytime.com. I'm going just to take things that we need for the lesson in order to understand Tomer Dvorah. So I'm using part of it to teach you Tomer Dvorah. But otherwise, if you need to see the portion of the week, go to TorahAnytime.com and look at the lectures that I gave you about Chumash, about Parashat Shmot, the portion of Shmot. And it's at the beginning it's written Be'ele Shmot Bnei Yisrael Abayim Mitzrayimah Et Yaakov Ishu Beito Bau, which means those are the names of the children of Israel that are coming to Egypt. Listen, are coming, not that came to Egypt, are coming now in the present tense, not in the past tense, to Egypt. Yaakov Ishu Beito, a person and all of the house, all of his household Bau, that came to Egypt. Now I would like to show you something. We read Tehillim all the time. Tehillim is a fixing. When we read Tehillim, we are fixing ourselves and this world. And I would like to show you. It says over here, I hope you can see it with this. Let's look at, I took this sentence and separated it into three sentences. You see it over here? And I would like to show you at the end of each word in each sentence, I would like to put, you know, a mark around it, and I would like to ask you from the first sentence, Be'ele Shmot Bnei Yisrael Abayim, Abayim, what do you see if you add all the letters? Be'ele Shmot Bnei Yisrael Abayim, you see the word Tehillim. You see Tehillim? Mm-hmm. I would like to show you. You see the word Tehillim? I don't have even something to wipe the board. Nitzchani Yarmisham Ken, Toda. Okay, so you see the word Tehillim. Now let's go to the next sentence. Bnei Yisrael Habaim Mitzrayim. What do you see over here? Bnei Yisrael Habaim Mitzrayim. Look at the word. We have Hey, Mem, Lamed, Beyud, Mila. You see the word Mila? Mila, circumcision. Toda Rabba. Circumcision, you see it? To circumcise a person. You see the word Mila? And then when we look at the last sentence, Mitzrayimah et Yaakov ish uveito, dear women, the word is tshuva. You see it? Look over, you see the word is tshuva? You see the last letters? Write it down, it's very important. Listen, dear women, it means that he who reads Tehillim can do tshuva over sins of Pgama Brit. Mila means Pgama Brit, which means incest. He who reads Tehillim can do tshuva over Pgama Brit. Incest, you know, forbidden intimate relationship. Do you understand? He who reads the Tehillim, the whole Tehillim. And I will ask you, why can he who reads Tehillim can do tshuva over Pgama Brit, over incest? Dear women, listen very carefully. King David wrote Tehillim, the whole book, in order that God will forgive him about what happened with Bathsheba. The whole book of Tehillim. So he who reads the whole book can do tshuva over Gama Brit, over incest. But it's more than that. He who reads Tehillim really does tshuva by reading the book of Tehillim. We know how many chapters do we have in Tehillim? 150, okay?
Everybody says 150.
I would like to tell you, dear women, 150.
מה זה אינסט בעברית?
סליחה?
מי שקורא תהילים עושה תשובה?
על פגם הברית. פגם הברית זו הוצאת זרע לבטלה. Dear women, listen very carefully. 150 chapters we have today in Tehillim. But when Tehillim was written, there was only 147 chapters. It was arranged differently. It's the same chapters, but it was arranged differently. Do you understand? The separation of the chapters was different. It was Kuf Mem Zayin, dear women. Kuf Mem Zayin. That's why, you know, Achronim, sages that are called Achronim, had problem with the Rambam. Because the Rambam said a few things about the Tehillim, and they said, but we cannot see the separation of the chapters in that way. Because truly the separation of the chapters was 147. That's why they had a problem. They did not understand what he was talking about. Who lived 147 years? Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu lived 100. Yaakov Avinu lived 147 years. So the Tehillim has 147 chapters like Yaakov Avinu. And why? Because, dear women, Abraham Avinu, Abraham was all kindness. Kuloya chesed. He was kindness, and you know he needed Sarah in order to have a little bit of judgment. Because he couldn't be. He worshipped Hashem in the measure of chesed. In the measure of kindness, total kindness. Achnasat Orchim, inviting people to his house from all sides, from all four sides of the wind. This was Abraham Avinu. You remember that when Sarah told him that she wants him to take away Hagar, to let them go from the house, Hagar and Ishmael, he didn't want to. He was angry and God said, no, listen to her. Everything she tells you, you should do. Because he didn't have judgment. And then we know that Yitzchak is called Pachad Yitzchak, the fear of Yitzchak. Yitzchak Avinu is all about judgment, everything din. Everything is judgment. When somebody has a lot of kindness, he worships Hashem in Chesed, you will see that everything is widened around him. Everything, his hands are open, everything is wide. When you have judgment, you are just like in a small, you know, small space. This is judgment, the tzimtzum, decreasing of things. But when you have kindness, this is increasing, the measure of increasing everything. But then, Yaakov Avinu, it's written about him, Ish Tam Yoshev Oalim. Which means an innocent person sits in the tents. What kind of tents? The tent between Avraham Avinu and Yitzchak. Look how beautiful it is. So here's Yaakov out of the letter Aleph. I'm giving you the Pardes. Out of the letter Aleph. So we see the Vav of the letter Aleph, like a Sofer Stam writes it, and then Yud and Yud. So here we have Chesed Avraham. Look how beautiful it is. One Yud is Chesed Avraham, on the right side, the Yud, and then the Yud at the bottom is Din Yitzchak, you see? Din Yitzchak, this is judgment, it's the left side, it's the left Yud. You see how beautiful? And in the middle is the Vav, is Yaakov. He sits between the tents of Avraham and Yitzchak. This is the letter Aleph. We have three, four, five.
זה האלף של אברהם?
אלף של אברהם, בכלל אלף באופן כללי, היוד הראשונה שנמצאת למעלה זה אברהם חסד, היוד שנמצאת למטה זה דין שמרכיבה את האלף, והוו זה התפארת.
Why are you saying that? How
wait, we're coming to it, we're studying. So look. מה? כן. So Yaakov is in the middle measure, and the middle measure that is always part of the ten measures is תפארת. This is, the Vav is the תפארת. This is Yaakov. So Yaakov is a mix of judgment and mercy. It's a mix. So only Yaakov Avinu was called Bchira Avot. The chosen of the forefathers was Yaakov Avinu. He is called in the Gemara Bchira Avot. Bchir Avot is, when you see Bchira Avot, it's Yaakov Avinu. And why is it Yaakov Avinu? Because he, only he can soften the judgments. Because he has in his measure judgment and mercy. And together he can soften the judgment. Because Yitzchak was the one that was sacrificed. This is din, this is judgment. Sacrificing is judgment. That's why this is Yitzchak. But Yitzchak has a big role when Mashiach comes. Because everything will be in judgment then. And then the only one that God is going to listen to him will be also Yitzchak. Not Abraham and not Yaakov, but Yitzchak. Because Yitzchak is judgment. So he can go and stand against everyone that will judge us. Because he's part of judgment. He's part of the measure of judgment. And it's in Masechet Shabbat, dear women. But I won't go to it now. So Tiferet is the measure of Yaakov. So Yaakov is mixed. Part of judgment and part of mercy. So only Yaakov... Only Yaakov can soften the judgments. Why? Because Avraham has only mercy. He cannot soften the judgment. And Yitzchak has only judgment. He works, worships Hashem in judgment. He cannot soften. He cannot do anything with the judgment. But Yaakov Avinu has both of them, so he can soften the judgment. And if you remember, the first human being sinned, had three sins. You remember? Avodah Zarah, worshipping another god by not listening to Hashem. And then Gilui Arayot, incest, because of what happened with a snake that he thought about Chava. And then the third thing was Shfichut Damim. Shfichut Damim, because of him there came death to the world. And Gilui Arayot, Avodah Zarah, Gilui Arayot v'Shfichut Damim. Dear women, and you remember that Avraham Avinu fixed. What did Avraham Avinu fix? The worshipping of another god. Ken, he went and told the world about Hashem. He announced Hashem in the world. And he broke all the idols. And then we had Yitzchak. What did Yitzchak do? Yitzchak fixed Shfichut Damim, murder, because he was willing to sacrifice himself. So he fixed this. And the last thing that was supposed to be fixed is incest. And who fixed it? Yaakov Avinu, which all of his children, Gilui Arayot, which all of his children were tzaddikim. So listen, Yaakov Avinu, that lived 147 years, that fixed the sin of Adam HaRishon, of the first human being, of incest, of Gilui Arayot, you know, immoral, intimate relationship. That's why the book of Tehillim is written with his number of years that he lived. Look how beautiful it is. And that's why it has the power to fix this. Because a man that Motzi Zera Levadala, look, Motzi Zera Levatala, instead of going to his wife, instead of getting married at an early age, that takes sperm, you know, in waste, his own sperm, because when a man takes his sperm and you know, uses it and throws it away without his wife, dear women, what happens is the man has all of his descendants in his mind. Each sperm is a descendant. Do you understand? Tzetzaim. It's like he's killing his own children and the children that he is supposed to have. And he takes off his luck in his own hands. Because Motzi Zera Levatala, the first words, the first letters, look, the first letters is Mazal. Mazal, the Mazal is taken away from him. He takes his Mazal away from him, his luck from him. But you know, the problem is that the men do not understand this. If they would have understood this, they would have gone and gotten married when they are young. 18 to 20 years old, they should get married in order not to have...
But it doesn't like...
Not everybody married at 17, 18.
That's right.
And Beseder, because not everybody knows. We need to learn. And once we know, we can spread the word around. Then this man takes his mazal away from him. This is Motzi Zera Levatala. He who takes out his sperm for... falseness, and I don't know how exactly to translate.
Waste.
For waste, exactly. Thank you. Okay, he who takes his sperm in waste, the Rashi Tevot, you take the first letters of the word, it's mazal, he takes off his luck. So the men that read the Tehillim, and you have to read it from the beginning till the end without stopping, but when you read the Tehillim, you're fixing yourselves, and this is a big schut, a big schut. And I would like to tell you, look over here. We see that the children of it, you see inside, it's beautiful to see how it's hidden inside the letters, inside the sentences. Dear women, there's a nut. Okay. Yaakov Avinu. שמיטתו הייתה שלמה. מיטתו הייתה שלמה. כן, הייתה שלמה. כולם צדיקים היו אצלו. ושפיכות דמים זה יצחק. כן. הנה השלושה. החלוקה.
147,
לא, לא. 147, ככה היה מחולק תהילים בהתחלה. ל-147, ככה שכתב את זה דוד המלך. אבל אחר כך שארגנו את זה מחדש, ארגנו את זה ל-150. ולמה 150? I'll explain. Here, I'll give it to you. It's part of the healing. It's beautiful. You ask the question, I'll show you. I didn't think of showing, but I'll show it to you. Dear women, look, it's beautiful. Anyway, we read Tehillim all the time. At least we will know what we're doing. So first of all, we know that we read Tehillim, אנחנו ממתיקים דינים. It's written, also להמתקת דינים, כתוב ככה, in chapter קוף וב, אני חושבת, תהילים קוף וב, בית קוף יוד, קוף וב. It's written in Tehillim 106, קוף וב is 106. It's written, can I wipe a little bit of the board? I'm wiping a little bit.
יכול להיות ש...
איפה?
אפשר לעשות גם כזה דבר ש-147 פלוס שלוש שנים שדוד היה אמור לחיות זה נהיה 150?
יפה, יפה, רעיון יפה, יישר כוח. But I have to tell you, there's עוד משהו. נירה, it suggests something beautiful. רואים, אני אומרת לך, מרגישים את הקשר. יישר כוח, באמת. You understand? I have to explain to you something. When you have a teacher that gives you a lesson, okay?
A good lesson.
Bezrat Hashem. I have to tell you.
Ben Porat Yosef.
Listen, dear women, when you have a teacher that gives you a lesson, then a tube of prosperity is opened from heaven. If the words are true, if it comes from the heart, because you have to cleanse yourself in order that everything that you take out of your mouth will go inside the hearts of the people that listen. And when they go out, back home, they are fed. The spirit has a spiritual food. Otherwise, it does not. It's like something went in one ear and went out of the other ear. It's like you didn't do anything. So you heard something nice and you went home. But you did not go with a mit'an, with a... איך אומרים מיטן באנגלית?
Knowledge?
With the knowledge or with... איך אומרים מיטן? שכחתי. Cargo. You do not go with a cargo with you. You leave it because you didn't get anything. In order to truly change from your heart, it has to go into your heart and into your veins. You have to feel. You have to feel the Torah. The Torah, I want to tell you, now we are in the times of Mashiach. We bring Mashiach by studying the Pardes of the Torah. This is the time of Mashiach. The merit is studying the Pardes of the Torah. This is the merit. And what we are doing here, we are studying the Pardes from all sides. And Nira said a beautiful thing. So if you feel, if I can see that the students also have the feeling and they have the ideas and they remember also the things that we are taught, it means Baruch Hashem, the Siyata Dishmaya, Ben Porat Yosef. Mama Siyata Dishmaya. So look over here, dear women. So Nira said that maybe it's 147 and the 3 years that David was supposed to live. You remember that I told you that David was supposed to live 3 years, 3 hours, and then pass away because of the punishment that the first human being received. You can look again at the lectures about David HaMelech. But then he received a present from the first human being of 70 years, and I explained to you why 70 years. And then the first human being regretted the present, and then he received the presents from Yosef, from Yaakov, and from Avraham Avinu. But let's continue. Why 150 eventually? So it's written, first of all, let me start with, remind me this question, I will answer it. It's written in chapter 106 in Tehillim, Mi emalel gvurot, mi...
Which chapter?
מי ימלא גבורות השם?
מי ימלא גבורות השם? I know it's very hard to...
ישמיע כל תהילתו. ישמיע כל תהילתו. Okay, it's chapter 1:6, verse 2.
Okay, 1:6, verse 2.
כל תהילתו.
ישמיע כל תהילתו, okay. It means, who is going למלל, to say that the judgments of Hashem, he is going to announce the praise of Hashem. Now, I would like to tell you something. From here, we study the Bnei Sachar, the rabbi that wrote Bnei Sachar, Rabbi Tzvi Elimelech Medinov, Zchutot Hagen Elenu, beautiful books he has. I would like to tell you, he says about it, from here you know that by reading Tehillim, we break, אנחנו קודשים, ממללים, זאת אומרת לקטוש, we break all the judgments from us, ממש, we break them. How do we break? Look, מי ימלל גבורות? גבורות is judgment. ימלל זה קטישה, which means breaking. Who is going to break judgment? גבורות is din. Who is going to break judgment? Gvorot Hashem, which means the Gvorot Hashem is the name of God of judgment. It means Elokim. Yashmiya kol tehilato. He who reads all the Tehillim in order to break all the judgments, the name of judgment of Hashem.
Ktisha
or ktiva? Yeah, toda. Okay, in order to lichtosh, to break all of the judgments of Hashem, you have to read the whole Tehillim. מי ימלל גבורות השם ישמיע כל תהילתו. And when you read the whole Tehillim, dear women, look.
It's written in the chapter. Oh, it doesn't go out.
Okay. With water maybe go.
Maybe more water. Okay, I'm gonna say. Okay, let's write over here.
אתה מנסה
קטישה.
אוקיי, בינתיים בוא נראה, let's write another chapter. יו, תודה.
זה תקלקלי, זה תקלקלי.
יש לך garlic, you put it in the thing and you press it, זה נקרא לקטוש שום. You like
breaking, to crush it. Yeah, that's the right word. In order to crush judgment, you have to read the whole Tehillim. Yashmi akol tehilato. So, dear women, in chapter 84 in Tehillim, Pei Daled, it's and read it in Mincha. The first, the chapter of Tehillim that you read in Mincha is Pei Daled. Is 84. It's written over there, Dror Ken La, which means it's like Dror means freedom. Ken means a nest of a bird, because you'll see it's all about a bird in that part. La, the nest for her. Dear women, pay attention. Dror means also freedom. Dror in Hebrew means also chofshi. Okay? Ken is 150. The whole chapters in Tehillim. You know what it takes away from us when you read the whole 150 chapters in Tehillim without getting angry, dear women? It takes all the ka'as of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, all the anger that we caused and the sorrow that we caused Hashem, it takes off of us. How? Because Kas, Chaf is in numerical value 20, Ayin is 70, and Samech is 60. So 60 plus 70 is 130, plus 20, 150. Ken, 150 chapters is against the anger of God. We are free of it if we read the Tehillim. Look how beautiful it is.
מה זה הכל? כעס למה?
כעס. מה?
זה כעס.
יכול להיות גם כולם ביחד. זה בטח. It can be one person that reads the whole Tehillim, and it can be a group of people that are reading the whole, but the condition is that we are going to read it without saying any word in the middle. We read it without speaking, just concentrating on what is written. And we try to read it in a song, in a singing way. Concentrating on what is written. So you can see that in Tehillim itself, King David gives hints how we can help ourselves and repent through the reading of Tehillim.
Ki ken,
begimatria, the kas. כי חף זה 20, ועין זה 70, וסמר זה 60. את מחברת זה 150. כן, זה 150. 150 פרקים של תהילים מורידים את הכעס של הקדוש ברוך הוא מאיתנו. אתם יודעים, you know what power?
Again, daily, daily dose, every day.
את יכולה לחלק את זה שזה שבועי, את גומרת התהילים בשבוע, את יכולה, איך שאת רוצה תחלקי את זה, לחודש את יכולה לחלק את זה, ואת קוראה את זה. העיקר שהכוונה כל זמן כן, אבל לא לדבר באמצע, do not speak in the middle. But I want to tell you, dear women, it's like the סיסמה, it's like the סיסמה, תהילים נגד תהילים, which means reading, the reading of תהילים against missiles. Truly, dear women, when we awake here, כשיש התעוררות דיל תתא, יש התעוררות דיל אלה, which means when we awake in this world, when we get awakened in this world, we cause the true world to be awakened too. So we can change by our deeds in this world, we can change things in the true world. ממש לשנות, we can do it, we have the power. We have the holy language in our mouths, and the השפה העברית and the language, the Hebrew language, is a language of shimautit, which means it's the essence of the being of the whole world. The whole world depends on the letters of the Hebrew Aleph Bet. The whole world was created by the letters of the Hebrew Aleph Bet. Bereshit bara Elokim et. First of all, he created the Aleph Bet from Aleph to Taf, et. First of all, before the heavens, before earth, before everything, the letters were created. After the letters, the Torah was written. And then God looked at the Torah and he created the world, Ken.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
The other day I was telling my children regarding this et, I was telling them your words, explaining them what et stands for. And they asked me another question. What about other situation when we see et, et umash or feilim or whatever?
It's addition. It's addition. There's a big thing that Rabbi Akiva wrote about et verak. Which means, what does it mean, et? So it's a big thing in the Gemara also. Rabbi Akiva wrote about it, and there was another rabbi that wrote about it. Everything that you see, et, is an addition. Tosefet, you add something, more and more. Because
you remember that, Zot HaTorah Shorsa, Zot HaTorah Shorsa Moshe. You remember on Shabbat, you say, when you read on Monday and Tuesday and Thursday, remind me, I have to give you everything today, I hope.
Monday and also Thursday, when we open a book of Torah, we say, Vezot HaTorah Shorsa Moshe. So we have et in the word zot. Can I wipe the board?
Mm-hmm. I know it's a balagan. It's very hard to understand. Talk about balagan. But I will try to give you whatever I can in this balagan.
You know, thanks so much for bringing all this up, because we take so for granted reading the Hillel.
No, so don't take it. It's mamash tikkun, it's a fixing.
Excuse me, in 48, which one?
84, verse 2. Okay, in the middle of the verse 2. You'll see it over there.
But did you use
In 84, no, it's not verse 2 in 84. I don't remember, I have to look inside. But it's 84.
But the dror ken la Hashem, what does it have to do? Meaning of dror, what does it do with the rest of it?
Dror is chofshi.
Yeah, I know.
As chofshi mikas. To be a God, yes, when you read the whole 150 chapters of Tehillim, you cause God to be free of his anger towards us. You cause this anger to go away from us. You understand? It's not God that is angry about us. It's all the mekatragim, all the ones that judge us because of our deeds. Ken, so, ma? Dear women, I will explain to you something. It's a good question. Bella asked a good question. Yes.
What's the question? I'm sorry.
Okay. So Bella asked, I have to give you another thing today, and it's very important. Bella asked, טוב, תיבריה, שבוע הבא בזאת. שאלתי שכי הפרשת חלה.
כן, בטח.
אני אוהבת אותך. כל טוב. תלכי לשלום. Dear women, she asked a good question. Where do those angels that come and prosecute us? מאיפה מגיעים המקטרגים? Dear women, from God nothing bad comes over here. God, from the measure of Keter, the crown, everything, it's important. Everything good comes from there. Only good. Everything good comes towards us. The snake does not kill. You know who kills? The sins. The snake does not kill. Even if he bites you, if you have not sinned, God will save you. Listen very carefully, only the sins, our sins, we should not blame anyone else. Our sins cause us, God forbid, to harm ourselves because the sins that we did and we did not do tshuva, there are bad angels on our left side. When a person goes, when a person passes away, the moments before he passes away, he sees the angel of death. And I told you, the angel of death, it's written in Avodah Zarah, Masechet Avodah Zarah, it's written that he has eyes. Why does he get in a state of panic? Because he sees all the number of sins that that person did in this life is the number of eyes the angel of death has. Shalonida, we want him to be blind, but no eyes. So it depends on us. And then those angels go with us. They are causing us the suffering, Shalonida, they cause us everything. You know, before a person goes into the grave, when they escort the person into the grave, listen, it's important. It says, Bashar Gilgulim, that all of his good and bad deeds go to the grave before him. They are he sees them. They're coming in front of him. And they show him everything he did, every word that we took out of our mouth. You don't, if we would have understood this, we would be afraid to say anything. Every word, every intention, every deed that we did comes in front of us. And then if this is a bad person, they go in front of him and they start shouting that this is a shame at this person that did not do what God wanted him to do. And after his deeds go into the ground, into the grave, then they put him into the grave. And then angels come to him and dig a big hole in the ground. We do not see it because then we put ground on him. We do not know what happens inside. But then it says that the angels dig a big hole in order that they can make him stand. So in the ground, he has, you know, the length of him. They dig a big, amok, deep inside the ground in order that he can stand. When he stands, then can, exactly, he has to stand like this, Shalom Eda. And then they ask him a question, what is your name? He doesn't know how to answer because even tzaddikim do not know because when they ask about the name, it means that from the first human being there was a shell because of his sin, there's a shell that everybody has. All of us, because of the curse of the death. So all of us have this shell. So what do? They take the person and they start to shake him with the hands and legs. The tzaddikim, a small shake, takes out this shell because they don't have any sins part of this. But the people that are wicked have so many sins that they just tear them apart. The body, and because the body, the soul and the body are together because they have to be punished together. And then they are torn to pieces. And then the angels take them and put them together again, the same image, and again they shake them. Shalom Eda.
If we're going to fix ourselves, and we're going to do tshuva, are we going to, is it going to happen to that person?
It depends only if you did true tshuva. You remember I told you last lesson? You remember that I told you from chapter 145 in Tehillim, we spoke about what happens to the people that fear Hashem and what happens to the people that love Hashem. If we work, you cannot skip to loving Hashem before fearing Hashem. Because if you don't have the fear of Hashem, you'll say, okay, I love Hashem, but I still don't want to do the commandments. I came here to have fun in this world, to live this moment. And to be met, to live, you'll listen to a lot of people say, okay, we came to this world, God wants me to be happy. So I'm happy, Baruch Hashem. I love God, but I'm happy. I do whatever I want. I don't follow His commandments. I don't go tsanua. Because why should I need it? But God knows that in my heart I love Him. This is not a true love, dear women. True love, when our children love us, they follow what we tell them to do. This is true love. When our child does not listen to us, it means that he does not truly respect us. He does not truly love us. Because if you love, you don't want the other person to have any sorrow. You want to save him from any sorrow. So you listen to him. That's when you love. So you are willing to sacrifice yourself instead of that person when you love someone. Truly love, because this is the essence of loving someone. This is Kiddush Hashem. Why do people do Kiddush Hashem? Are willing to die on the name of God? Because this is the true love that is awakened inside a person. Because those are the two commandments that we receive from Hashem directly. Anochi Hashem Elokecha, lo yu lecha elokim acherim. So two commandments are sealed in our hearts. They cannot go away because this we heard the word of Hashem directly. Not from Moshe Rabbeinu, directly from Hashem. So those two things, that's why we are willing, even if we do not follow the commandments, when it's time of a question, there's a question of belief in Hashem, then there are people who are willing, even though they did not follow the commandments their whole life, willing and to die for the name of God. But this is because it's sealed inside them, dear women. So when we love Hashem, God says when you fear Hashem, in chapter 145, King David says, Retzon Yerav Yaseh, the will of his of the people who fear him, he's going to do, God is going to do, by Hashem, and he's going to save them. But, Ketuv Shomer Hashem et kol ha'avav et kol ha'reshaim yashmi, but when people love Hashem, which means that they already have the merit to elevate themselves to the love of Hashem by following His ways. You remember the diagram that we did? By following His ways. So by following His, which means listening to His commandments. If I need to go with a cover on my head, I will go with a cover. Because I'm not, my purpose in life is not to be to look beautiful in front of other people. First of all, to be beautiful in the eyes of Hashem. First of all, that God will be happy with me. Dear women, I'll tell you a secret. If God is happy with you, everyone will see you as a beautiful woman. Everyone. You will have chen. You will have this beauty that comes from Hashem. You will be beautiful. You don't even, you can go tznua. You can go with a cover on your head. And God will see to it that everybody will like you. You'll be just like Esther HaMalkah. That was old when she got married to Ahasuerus. And it says in the Midrash that she even had green face. And still everybody loved her and she was the most beautiful girl over there. Dear women, it's because God put His grace on her. So when you follow the ways of Hashem, your husband will feel that you are the most beautiful woman in the world. He won't look at anyone else, do you understand? But you have to have a true belief. That your heart and your mouth are even. You have to speak to Hashem. I told you that you have at least 10 minutes every day or half an hour. Just take time to speak to Hashem. Tfilah d'oraita. It's a prayer from the Torah, which without a siddur, just speak to Hashem and tell Him everything that you want. Everything. So first of all, you have to start with thank you. You have to thank Hashem, Bezrat Hashem. You have to thank Hashem. We start with thanking Hashem. And then we can ask Hashem for everything. And please don't forget to ask for Klal Yisrael. All of the children of the Israel. And don't forget to ask for Mashiach with mercy. And I would like to tell you, dear women, I have to do to skip to go to do another thing with you. This week we are starting Parashat Shovavim. We are starting Shuvu Banim Shovavim. It's written in Yirmiyahu chapter 3. I hope I can write it over here. It's written in the prophet Yirmiyahu, Shuvu Banim Shovavim. It's important that it's connected to Tomer Dvorah because this is the time of Tshuva, dear women. Chapter 3 in the prophet Yirmiyahu, it's written, Shuvu Banim Shovavim, return to me, naughty children, naughty sons. These 6 weeks from this week till the end, look over here, these 6 portions of the week from now, from this week, those are the times that we can repent over our sins. They are very, it's like the gate is open to repent. Why? Because those are called the weeks of Shovavim, of naughtiness. כל השבועות, אלה שישה שבועות נקראים שבועות שובבים. And why? Because Shin comes for Shmot, for the portion of the week of Shmot. You see over here? Vav is Vayera, the next week's portion of the week. Bet is Bo, and then Beshalach. You have twice Bet, you see it over here? Yud is Itro, receiving the Torah. And Mem is Mishpatim. Look over here, dear women. Shuvu banim shovavim. which means that Arizal, Zchutot HaGadol, says those are the weeks that Yirmiyahu the prophet was considered them as weeks of doing tshuva. That's why he says shuvu banim shavavim. Shavavim, naughtiness, stands for all of these six portions of the week that starts from this week, Bezrat Hashem. Shemot vayera bo b'shalach ito v'mishpatim. When we have a leap year, there are two more weeks that are called Truma and Tetzaveh. Dear women, when we have a leap year, this year is not a leap year, so there are 6 weeks. Usually the minhag, the custom in these 6 weeks, dear women, is that on Monday and Thursday, when the Book of Torah is opened in the shul, usually you'll see this is called Tzomot Shovavim. Tzomot, the fast of Shovavim. Tzomot Shovavim is the fast of Shovavim. You'll see that usually there are men that fast. They have a ta'anit. Ta'anit is not a fast of 24 hours. Ta'anit is a fast from sunshine to sunset. Okay, when the sun starts to shine to sunset after the stars goes out, then those usually on Monday and Thursday, you'll see men that are in ta'anit. It's called Tzomot Shovavim, in order to cleanse the ken. Yes, if you want to do a ta'anit, you have to in mincha the night before. Ken, when we say Shema Kolenu, then you have to say Shabli Neder Ba'erev. Tomorrow we're going to have a ta'anit. Then you can say in Shacharit of the ta'anit of the fast. Then you can say Anenu, Anenu Hashem Anenu. But usually you'll see men doing it on Monday and Thursday when the Book of Torah is open in the shul, because those have the essence and the power for tshuva, mamash, all these 6 weeks. And why, dear women? Because you remember I told you in Minchot, in Masechet Minchot, it's written over there that he who studies chatat, he who studies sins, all of the things that, the sacrifices you have to bring if you sin, kilu ikriv chatat. It's like he gave a sacrifice of sin. He who studies asham, which means when we are guilty of something bad that you did, and you study all of the laws about giving a sacrifice about asham, it's like you gave a sacrifice of asham, which means v'neshalma parim sfatenu, by studying the Torah, by reading it, by having the kavanah, the intention when we read it, we can cause ourselves actions. When we read the Torah, we can do tshuva for ourselves. If we read about chatat, about the sacrifices of sins, and we read about it, and we thought about it, and we said, wow, it's like we really did it in true action, we did it. Only by reading and saying the words, taking them out of our mouth, it's like we did it. So when we sit down and study and read these portions of the week, it's like each of us, you remember that it's written Habayim Mitzrayimah, which like is coming to Egypt, is going to Egypt right now in the present tense. It's like we went to Egypt and now we are cleansing ourselves from all of our sins. Do you understand? When we have the intention, when we read it. So it's like, mamash, we are doing it. We are part of it. And if we suffer and when we feel bad for all the Jews that were there, and we have the feeling, it's like we are part of it, dear women. Then we are also doing the fixing of this exile. Because I already told you that the Arizal said that this generation, the generation of Mashiach, is the generation of Mitzrayim, the generation of the Jewish people that went out of Egypt. And who are the Jewish people that came to Egypt? They were the Be'etzem Gilgul, the reincarnation of Dor HaMabul and Dor HaPalaga. Two generations, Dor HaMabul, the generation of the flood of Noah, and the generation that built Migdal Babel, the Tower of Babel, the generation of the separation. The ones that built Migdal Babel, they are the ones that went out down to Egypt as the Jewish people, because they had to fix themselves. The people that sinned, the generation that sinned in the generation of Noah, what did they sin with? Part of it was Gilui Arayot, Gilui incest. Okay, it means that they had an immoral relationship, intimate relationship How did God fix it? Kol ha-ben ayor ha-shlichu, which means that he took their seeds that they threw in the generation of the flood, and Paro took their children and threw them to the Niles. Do you understand? It's a measure for measure. Midah keneged midah. This is how the world works. Midah keneged midah. If we will be true to ourselves, we will see that everything that happens in our lives is measure for measure. We get back. If we did something bad, it comes back to us. It does not go away because the angel that we created wants to get even with us.
It's even worse.
You see, because God knows how the other, how our action influenced another person. We do not know. We did already the actions, but we don't know the sorrow of this person or what happened to him. But God does. So we get measured, God forbid, measure for measure. And then we can see that the generation of the Palaga, which means that built the tower in Babylon.
They were Jewish?
No, but the reincarnation after that was in them. Because all of those generations, there was no Jews. Laya Yehudim, only from Abraham Avinu it started. So we can see that the generation that built the tower, they worshipped another god. They wanted to worship another god. Avodah Zarah, nachon? That's what they did. And then they build the tower, havan ikach lanu levanim. So God said, you took levanim, bricks, to build the tower. You're going to work with bricks. Listen very good. We're going to work. You build the tower, you're going to build two cities in Egypt. Pitom Baram says, two cities they built. It's not that. People think that we built the pyramids. We did not build the pyramids. The Jewish people built, Pitom Baram says, two cities. What were the cities that we built? You remember that Yehuda, Beparashat Vayigash, Yehuda was standing with Yosef, and he was speaking to him, and he was very harsh. And when Yehuda got angry, and he raised his voice, two cities were ruined in Egypt. Pitom Baram says, can you think about it? Today, you know, there are people that try to make weapons by... sound waves, exactly, because every building, everything has its own its own wave, and when you concentrate on the wave of the building, you can ruin the whole building without doing anything, just by the sound wave, everything will crush. So Yehuda, look how they were so strong. It says that Yehuda was shouting until two of the cities, Pitom Baram says, were crushed, were ruined. Who built those cities again? The Jewish people. We built them. So, dear women, Be'ezrat Hashem, in order that we will do the fixing and we won't have to do another fixing, and Be'ezrat Hashem, she'gei Mashiach Tzidkenu b'Ramei Amenu Amen, we should study those six portions of the week very carefully, read them at home. Very carefully, and try to have the feeling like we were there doing it, in order to repent. Read the book of Tehillim, Be'ezrat Hashem. It's part of our essence, part of doing the fixing of our measures. This is the book of Tehillim. When you read it and you concentrate on the words, you can feel it. And dear women, I'd like to bless you. Be'ezrat Hashem, she'gei Mashiach Tzidkenu b'Ramei Amenu Amen. She'gei v'sariyahu nevi'yahu tishvi'yahu ben Ramban Moshech ודוד אליהו וזכור לכל.
Amen.
לעולם יברד אדם מחברו וידבר הלכה יחיד ברבים הלכה כרבים.
Amen.
God bless you.